Welcome, I'm Jan Kugel and this is another episode of Letters to Avoid, a series about GMP where we take a look at FDA warning letters and break them down. Today I will talk about mistakes you should avoid when investigating out-of-specification test results in finished drug products. The examples I bring are from a warning letter sent to Teligent Pharma in November 2019. The company produces injectable antibiotics and topical products like medicinal ointments and creams. The hero of the story today is a product of theirs named clobetazole propionate. It is used for treating different skin conditions like dermatitis. The FDA auditor that visited the company reviewed their records and found a batch numbered 8922, which the company released under suspicious circumstances in 2017. During release testing of the lot, chemists determined an OOS in impurity. The company then followed up with a retest and after some manipulation of the samples, got passing results. In root cause analysis, they blamed the sample preparation, claiming that the lot interacted with something which caused the impurities. Next, they brought the product to the market without any hard evidence to what caused the deviation. Strike one. Then, the FDA auditor looked at the 18-month stability studies of the same lot, 8922. Now guess what the chemist found when he retested the batch? Yes, a new impurity OOS. But this time, the peak was in a different retention time. Therefore, they didn't connect the result with the first OOS. Instead of investigating the matter further, the company concluded that the impurities were not product related, rather probable contamination from the glassware. Strike 2. The story of the infamous lot 8922 doesn't end here. The FDA auditor looked at a test from the 9-month interval where the lot got an OOS also in the related compounds test. Did the company investigate the issue? Yes, after full 9 months had passed. And yet again, they concluded that the deviation was not product related, closing the case. Strike 3. Needless to say, the company's actions were unacceptable. Such misconduct can easily lead to consumers being hurt. This time the product was a cream, next time it could be an injectable antibiotic. Now, what should have the company done? First, they should have conducted an extensive root cause analysis to understand the origin of the impurities. If they did something wrong during preparation, it is also a deviation and they need to understand the origin of it too. Or maybe they need to update their procedures. If the impurities come from their glassware, they should investigate the issue and contact the supplier. Second, they should have also identified the impurities to prove that they weren't product related as they claimed. Third, they should have extended the investigation to other batches to see if their claims are correct. And fourth, last but not least, they should have created a CAPA plan, making sure that such a deviation doesn't happen again. Is there something else that you would have done? Leave your thoughts in the comment section. If you found the video interesting, please share it. If you haven't done it yet, subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on LinkedIn. Stay compliant and see you in the next video.